I've made a copy of ODB22 query wildcard, but this time I made some more changes to that file that we'll see in a minute. So if you want to work along with this file, you'll want to download ODB23 Nulls Before from the website. I've made a copy of that file, and I'm calling this one ODB23 Nulls After. And I'll put this out on the website as well. The simple explanation of what nulls are is, nulls are what are in a table field if no data was ever entered. To explain this better, let's open up our table in edit mode, going into tables, right-clicking, and edit. This first field here, employee ID, that is a key field. We also have this one as auto value. LibreOffice will create a value for this, so this field won't apply. Let's look at the next field, last name. Down in our field properties, we see that this entry is required. This field must have a value to create a record. So this field too cannot have a value of null. The first name, same as last name, can't have a value of null. When we get to gender in all the fields after, we see entry required equals no. That means all of these fields have the potential of having a value of null. This all sounds simple, but now we're going to look at some data, see where people get confused, and try and clear up that confusion. Let's open up this employee table. Looking at our data, most of these fields are populated. When we get to end date, a lot of these fields are not populated, and it's pretty safe to say that those values are going to be null. When we look over into the department column, we see that we're missing a couple of departments. Those are the changes I made to this file just before I started the video. Let's close our table and open up a new query in design view. We're going to add our table. Now we want the employee ID, last name, first name, and we're also going to add in the end date. Let's run this query as it is, and we see we've got 28 records. Now we want to see all the records that have null for end date. So I'm going to come down to our criterion and type in is null. Pressing enter to lock it in. It changes this to say is empty. I'm going up to run the query, and we see we've got 23. We see all the end dates have nothing in them. To prove this is working properly, we also want to see all the end dates that are not null. To do that, we will add in not before the empty. Pressing enter to lock it in, and pressing F5 to run the query, we see we've got 5 records. 5 and 23 is 28. That accounts for all our records. Let's see how this looks in SQL view. We've got our single line. I'm going to reformat that. We see our query is pretty much how we'd expect it. Down under our where, we've got our field name, then is not null, and the is not null has no quotes around it. I'm going to run this to show it's running. I'm going to change this to is null. Pressing F5 to run it again. We see our 23 records, so this works well. I'm going to save this query as ODB23 query null. Let's go back over to design view. Coming back into design view, we see that our criterion has changed back from is null to is empty. A lot of database programmers are going to have a problem with this being is empty because they say is empty is not the same thing as is null. Let's take another look at our table. And we see we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 records that do not have a department. Let's change this to department. And we'll see is empty. Pressing F5, we see we've got two. When we come back, is not null. Pressing F5, we have some in here that look empty that do not come up under is null. Since we just learned about wildcards, let's add a wildcard and change this to say like asterisk space asterisk single quote, pressing enter to lock that in, and then pressing F5 will now tell us if we have one or more spaces hiding in that department field. And we see we've got two records that have spaces, and we have two that have nulls, but we still have two that aren't accounted for. They don't have spaces and they don't have nulls. They must have something else. So if I change my criterion now to say equals, I'm hitting space, then I'm going to put in two single quotes right next to each other with nothing in between. This would mean empty or nothing to some database programmers. I'm going to hit enter to lock that in, and then F5. And we see we've got two records that have nothing in there. And this is the issue that some database programmers have. To them, this means nothing, and nulls is a value of nulls. I'm going to say equals nothing or is null. Pressing enter, then pressing F5 to run it. There's four of our six records with nothing in there. And now I also have to say or like single quote asterisk space asterisk single quote, enter, pressing F5, and that accounts for all six of our records that have no value in the department. But two of them have spaces, two of them are null, and the other have nothing in there, which is why some database programmers say that null is not the same as empty. Let's go over to SQL view and take a look at it there. Looking at our SQL, the select and the from, those are the same as we've seen, and the where. We've got department equals the two single quotes next to each other. Below that we have is null, and below that they're asking if there are any spaces. The difficult way to explain nulls is to say that it is different than having no value, because nulls is a value, and depending on the database system you're using, it may put a character or some kind of value in there representing null.